Everybody, this is Pastor Ben Lim here, and there seems to be a civil war in the church. I said it, a civil war in the church. In fact, in these end times, it seems like there's going to be much more deception and even more division. But we need to continue to stand forth with the truth of God's word. The enemy wants to do away with God's infallible written Bible, with the infallible written Logos word. But we know that the word of God is eternal and will never fail. You see, the definition of civil war means a war between the same nation. We see even in the book of Genesis that ever since Adam and Eve fell into sin, there seemed to continuously be a conflict and a war between them. The Bible even says with Cain and Abel, there was a murder, there was innocent bloodshed, the first murder that took place against human beings. There was a civil war, a rivalry between brothers. We even see with Isaac and Ishmael, there was a rivalry between brothers. It seems like the devil wants brothers and sisters to continue to fight one another. But we are not the enemy. Human beings are not the enemy. It doesn't matter how evil or how bullying or how much somebody in your life may be trying to put you down. Human beings are not the enemy. The devil is. Evil spirits that are operating and moving through each person, that is the enemy. The devil is the enemy, not your people that are coming against you. So the Bible here says that we should be able to forgive our enemies. In Matthew 5:44, it says, I tell you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. Love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. You see, there seems to be a civil war in the church. Continual factions, sects, divisions, denominations, groups, fellowships, alliances, and there seems to continuously be different groups that are being broken down. The Apostle Paul says in the book of Corinthians, are you in Apollos or are you in Paul? At that time, there was much debate and arguing about which apostle was better, which religious line was greater. But Apostle Paul says, it's not Apollos who saved you, and it's not Paul that saved you, but it's only Christ. The civil war in the church takes place when we focus on minor issues rather than the central things that unite us and bring us together. In this time, we must be gracious. We must be able to forgive. We must be humble. We must be quick to forgive. We must be people that are quick to listen rather than point fingers and judge. Too many of us are being used by the accuser of the brethren, pointing fingers, blaming others rather than loving, rather than being kind, being understanding, choosing to forgive. You and I, we are meant to bless those who curse us. There seems to be a civil war in the church where more and more we're trying to fight brothers and sisters. But we should be people that stand in the gap, just like Christ Jesus did, and bring unity and love where there's hatred, bitterness, and where there's division. You see, the Leviathan spirit is trying to destroy and divide the church. But we will not stand the tactics of the enemy. We will not stand for Leviathan. But we will rise up and we will truly be born of the Spirit of God. And we will see an awakening and a revival and a renewal like never before. The civil war in the church is going to continue on if we do not humble ourselves, if we do not pray and seek the face of God. Brothers and sisters, you and I, we need to seek His face rather than wanting to be right. God bless you. This is Pastor Ben talking about the civil war in the church.